Hello students, in our previous presentations we have tried to cover various aspects of sliding coated bearing and also tried to understand the design procedure of sliding coated bearing. This presentation intends to solve some numericals on sliding coated bearing which is required for understanding the concepts in a better way. I have tried to take some problems, and these are unsolved problems, and we'll solve these problems one by one and try to utilize the concepts that we have already covered in the previous presentations. Before starting solving the numericals, let us once again understand the design procedure of hydrodynamic bearing or sliding coated bearing. This procedure we have covered in detail in previous presentations. I would like to mention one thing over here, that this is general procedure. In every question, we may not require to follow all the steps laid down in this slide. For example, if in some question we have been given value of radial clearance or value of minimum film thickness, we'll take that value from the numerical and find other parameters which are required. So this is a general procedure which is being used when we have been given very few parameters, like only load is given, RPM is given, and die of journal is given. In other cases, when we are being given sometimes, say viscosity is to be taken as some certain value, or H0 is to be taken like that, so we'll skip that particular step in this design procedure. It is R by C whole square mu ns upon P. In this question, we have been given R radius, C radial clearance, mu viscosity, but we have been given viscosity in terms of centipoise. So we need to convert into SI units, because mu is in SI units, megapascal second or newton second per meter square. P is bearing pressure. Bearing pressure can be easily found by load, that is 50 kilonewtons upon area, that is length of journal and diameter of journal. So P can be found. R and C is given. This equation is having two unknowns now. One is Sofen number and other is NS. So what we'll do with our understanding of the design procedure, we'll take help of Raimondi and Boyd chart, so that we can found what will be S for the given value of H0 by C, because H0 is given to us and C is also given to us. So first of all, we found what is pressure. It came out to be 2.22 megapascal, which you can see over here. And then H0 by C is being given as 0.2. Now next, what we'll do, as discussed right now, we'll take help of Raimondi and Boyd table, that is page number 16.49, table 16.6 from the generator book by V. Vandari. This is something like this. This is a snapshot of that table. We can see that for H0 by C of 0.2, we have S, corresponding S is 0.0446. for L by D1. So from here we'll take value of S as 0.0446, and for this value of S we can put in the formula for Sofen number, and there only unknown was NS, so we can easily find speed of journal in revolutions per second. That came out to be 49.5 revolutions per second, and we can convert that into RPM. So N is 2973 RPM is the required answer. So you can see that the procedure is very straightforward. There is nothing difficult in it. We can easily find the required parameters by simply looking into the fact that what is being given to us. Coming to the next question. In this question, we have been given journal diameter, bearing length, radial load, journal speed, radial clearance, and viscosity of lubricant. We need to find what is minimum film thickness, that is H0, what is coefficient of friction, that is F, and what is power lost in friction, that is nothing but heat generated, or F into W, which is radial load, into V, which is speed of journal, velocity of journal. So, adopting the same procedure that we have adopted in the previous problem, we can easily find what is S over here, because in this question we have been given R. R is 50 mm. C is 0.12 mm. Mu, we'll convert mu, we have been given Z, so we'll convert that into mu, that is 16 over 10 to the power 9. We'll put over here, and pressure we can find since load is given to us, length and diameter we know already, so it come out to be 5 MPa. So everything required to determine Swammerfeld number is with us, so we can easily find the Swammerfeld number. Putting all these values in the equation, we find Swammerfeld number S as 0.0133. Now, referring to the same Raymondian word table, we find that we don't have exact value of S 0.0133, because we have got S as 0.0188 and 0.00474. So our S is lying somewhere in between these two values. That means we need to take help of interpolation to find what would be H0 by C for this S and other parameters, FR by C. So by interpolation, we'll find H0 by C and FR by C, because H0 is unknown to us and F is also unknown to us. Referring this procedure, we can find minimum film thickness. So by interpolation, our H0 by C was 0.0726. H0 by C is this, and we already know what is C, so we can find H0, that is 0.0087 mm, which is required answer. Then came friction coefficient. By interpolation, FR by C is 0.84, or F is 0.84 into C by R. It came out to be 2.01 into 10 to the power minus 3, which is also required answer. Then in the last, it is power loss in friction. The formula is friction coefficient into radial load into velocity. F we have already found, W is 50 kN, and velocity is pi d n upon 60 in meters per second. So power loss in friction came out to be 757 watts or 0.76 kilowatt. So you can again see within very short span we can solve such numerical. Let us come on to question number 3. In this question, apart from other things that were already there in the previous question, there is one data which is unique, unlike previous questions. It is class of fit, H7E7. And we need to find dimensions of bearing, minimum film thickness, and requirement of oil flow. Since L by D is given to us, pressure is given to us, and load is given to us, we can easily find what would be dimensions of bearing. So for this case, L and D come out to be 100 mm. Now, a little consideration will show that this class of fit has something to do with radial clearance, because we know that for H7, there ought to be certain size of hole plus minus, and E7 also there is ought to be certain size of shaft plus minus. So we'll take help of that. Corresponding to H7 E7, hole limits are this and shaft limits are this. This is again we have to refer table 3.10 on page 3.9 and table 3.15 on page 3.14 in the design data book by V. Bhandari. So we can find to what extent our hole size will vary and our shaft size will vary. Correspondingly, we can find what is average diameter of bearing D, capital D, and average diameter of journal, small d. This information is used to find riddle clearance because we want to enter Riemondian void table, and for that we require either H0 or S. So with this we found what is C, and keeping putting the value of C in here, C here, because mu in terms of Z was given, NS is known to us, pressure is known to us, C we have already found, R is being, we have already determined, so S came out to be 0.1048. Now for L by D 1 and S equals to 0.1048, we can easily found from the Riemondian void table what would be H0 by C, what would be FR by C, what would be Q upon RC NSL. Again, this S, exact value of this S is not available in the table. So we'll again take help of interpolation method. We found, as in previous question, minimum value of minimum film thickness. By interpolation, we found H0 by C as 0.3576 and H0 as 0.019 mm. Similarly, we found what is Q upon RC NSL, and since R, C, NS and L are known to us, we can easily found what is Q, oil flow, came out to be 17,618.8 millimeter cube per second, or we can convert that into liters per minute, and it came out to be 1.057. Riemondi and Boyd table and charts are very useful in solving questions on sliding audit bearing. We need to enter the table with only two values, either H0 by C and L by D or HS and L by D, and we can find many more parameters, and those are dimensionless parameters, and we can find FR by C, Q upon RC and L, and many more parameters we can easily find. So within the short span, we were able to solve three questions. This is one more variant of problems. Here we are given bearing diameter, journal diameter, bearing length, journal speed, riddle load, and viscosity of lubricant. Now we have been mentioned, it has been mentioned that the bearing is machined on lathe from bronze casting, while a steel journal is hardened and ground. The surface roughness values for turning grinding are 0.8 and 0.4 microns. For thick film lubrication, minimum film thickness should be 5 times the sum of surface hardness values for the journal and the bearing. We need to find permissible minimum film thickness, actual film thickness under the operating conditions, and power lost in friction. When we studied the design parameters, we found that H0 depends on the surface roughness of bearing and the journal. So this values which are given over here, they relate to what would be the minimum film thickness. Since it has been given that permissible minimum film thickness should be 5 times surface roughness, so it came out to be 6 microns. It is permissible film thickness. Actual film thickness we need to find from Riemondi and Boyd table. For that we found what is riddle clearance, because D, capital D and small d were all already given to us. It came out to be 0.045 millimeter, and bearing pressure is 3.2 megapascal. With these informations, we can easily find what would be sum of it number. Do not forget to convert Z into mu. Sum of it number came out to be 0.0277. Again, we went to that Raimondian word table. Again, exact value of S is not available. So, we will take value in between these two. And by interpolation, we will find H0 by C and RC by F. H0 by C came out to be 0.1349 or H0 is 0.00607 mm or it is 6.07 microns. So, permissible was 6 and actual is 6.07 microns. Then, from the same Raimondian word table, we found what is FR by C by interpolation. F come out to be 1.14 into 10 to the power minus 3. Then, we found what is HG or heat generated, which is FWV. We keep the value of F, this is W, 8 kN, and pi dN upon 60. Mind you need to put value of V in meters per second. So Hg comes out to be 68.7 watts or 0.068 kilowatt. Few questions that we have tried to solve with the help of procedure that we have learnt in our previous presentations. You should try more such questions to develop better understanding of design of sliding coated bearing. I hope you have enjoyed the presentation. Thank you for your patient hearing.